So if you formatted your CF cards or your SD cards, I was just in the exact same situation. I formatted one of the CF cards, actually one of the camera operators I was working with formatted it in camera, and I was able to recover 98% of the information after about 2 days of research. So I wanted to make this video, show you what software I used and how I was able to recover that information. Now, the key is that you formatted the card, but you didn't record over the card. Now, if you recorded over the card that you already formatted, I don't know of any way that you could recover that information, but if you just formatted the card in camera, in a computer, and you haven't rewrote anything on that card, the information is actually there. Even though the card shows 0 megabytes on the card, the information is actually there and it's recoverable with recovery software. Now, I know there's some free options out there. I tried many, many options, but let me show you the software that didn't cost very much. So if this is important to you, spending 40, 50 bucks, it's not a big deal to recover your information. And this is the software I use. So let's jump into the computer. I wanna show you what software I use and I wanna show you the process of recovering a deleted card. So the one software that I mentioned to you is called Disk Drill, and I'll have a link in the description and you could download it for Mac. This is the download for Mac up here and this is the download for Windows. I'm using it on a Mac and it worked great. So if you have a Mac, go ahead and download it. And you could upgrade to a Pro, but there is a free download that shows you some of the files that it could actually recover. And then you could upgrade if you think it's worth the money and it found the files for you. So let me go ahead and minimize this. Next is we want to go ahead and plug in the card that has been formatted. So I'm just using a CF card reader and this is the card. So if I press Command I on my Mac to see the file size, you could see it's completely empty. So available 32 gigs basically, and capacity is 32 gigs. I'll open it up and there is a content because this was formatted in camera, but there is actually nothing here within that content folder. There's nothing here, only 2.6 megabyte worth of information in this index file, but no video files. And this is a full card, so there should be 32 gigs worth of video files that have been formatted. So let's go ahead and recover that. So I'm gonna install and download Disk Drill. I've already installed it. So again, go through the process of installing it through the website. It's pretty straightforward. And once you launch Disk Drill, see, I have the pro version because I paid for it to recover, but you don't have to do that just yet. You could do the scan without doing that. But once you're ready, this is where you would get the license. So all your drives show up. So all my external drives, internal drives, they all show up. But what I care about is this 32 gig card right here, the CF card. It's showing it here and here. It's the same card. So in one of these options, I want to go ahead and press the settings option. And I want to run all recovery methods. So I'm gonna go ahead and select that. That will run all the recovery methods. Again, you could do it here or here, it doesn't matter. So let me go ahead and press that. And once you're on this page and it's actually doing the recovery method, let me expand this a bit. You want to make sure that all files are selected. You could even select all files, including hidden files, but don't select pictures, video. This actually is a good way to sort out what files is scanning, but at least this way you know it's scanning the entire card. And make sure over 0K, so 0 kilobytes is, so that's everything. And make sure delete it within the last any time. So make sure it pulls up anytime. Even if you formatted your card recently, this is, let's say, within a day or two. This way, you know everything that's recoverable within that file is recovered. So let me let this finish. In this case, I think last time I did it, it took about 15 minutes or so. It says it's going to take 4 minutes. So let's see. But depending on the size of your card, this is a 32 gig card. It could take a bit of time. So let this play out and I'll jump back in when it's done. Okay, looks like the scan is completed. And as you could see, there's a couple of different things that he found here. So let me go ahead and expand these to see what he found. So it looks like he found some video files. So if I expand this, it found MXF files. Let me go ahead and expand these. And he found 19 different files here. And MXF is the file type that this camera shot in. I shot on a Canon C300 and it shoots in this file format. So I will have to convert these eventually to MP4, MOV or whatever I want, but these are the files that were lost. Again, as you could see on the actual card, there's no files there. It just says the entire card's available, but those files are here. So if you see these files, what you want to do is select video, or whatever files you want to recover, and then press the recover icon here. Or you could say there's a chance to find more data. You could say scan entire disk. This will do another run, which will take about the same amount of time the first scan took. But if you don't see what you want here, just go ahead and do that to make sure it's scanning everything you want. And once you're done, go ahead and select the video files. Let's select or photo files or audio files, whatever you have. And then press recover. And it's going to start recovering those files and putting them in the folder that I selected. These are the file sizes in that file. Again, this worked for me on a CF card, an SD card. The only time this didn't work for me, and I didn't really need it, I was just doing a test for this video, is when I used a Sony FS5 and I formatted the card inside the camera, and this program was not able to find anything for me. So in a case of this program not working for you, let me just show you. This actually finished one of them. So let me show you that file. There is that file. It's putting it in this file structure for me that I pre-selected before. And once it's done, I also have this other program. Let me just go ahead and launch this just so you have a reference to it. I don't even have it purchased on this computer, but I'll leave the link in the description for this program. But you could add files from your desktop here. So if I added some of the recovered files that I had here, let's say this file here, file number one, I could just open it here. And then I could go ahead and convert this to an MP4, for example. So this is what I use to convert if your file structure is different than what you want to end up with. And while this is still working, let me show you a couple other programs that I used. Again, this drill is my favorite, but I did buy a couple other programs. I bought this one, Ease US Data Recovery Wizard. This actually did a pretty good job too, recovering these files for me. Found these MXF files on that card for me. So again, this reads the disk. It kind of works in the same process. It's going to go ahead and pull up your disk. You'll have to select your card and then press scan, and that will complete the scan. And another one I actually didn't buy because these worked for me was Image Rescue. And Image Rescue kind of works through the same process. You could go ahead and scan your card here. This is made by Lexar, which is the card company I actually was using when this happened. So you could go ahead and scan and go through the same process. So between those three different apps, you'll probably have good success. Again, this drill worked well for me. If none of these work for you, you should find a recovery center near you. So go ahead and Google a recovery center, and they may be able to do this in-house for you. They also use software similar to these, so it's unlikely that they're going to be able to recover it. So if at all possible, I would suggest reshooting, if it's possible, reshooting what you lost if these methods don't work for you. But the last resort is calling one of those recovery centers. So hopefully they could recover the data for you. Anyway, I hope you found this useful and you were able to recover your data. Please leave a comment and let me know if these methods worked for you. And give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. I post tech tutorials just like this one 5 times a week. And I really hope to see you on the next video. Thanks for watching this one.